Hello, ladies and gentlemen. You have probably seen me as a herald the last few days, but I'm also a speaker for this final last lightning talk. My name is Fons Bloemen. I'm a security architect of the Ziggo, one of the big providers here, and also had been working at KPN for a long time. And during this work, I have seen the other part of the abuse handling process. And this process has a lot of question marks and problems. The main problem is that there is a lot of information which is available for the abusers, but it's not accessible for them because they have to do too much. They have to make too much work of it to get the information inside and to process it. Most of these processes are way and way manual. Now, I decided to do something about this, and together with some other of the Dutch ISPs, we call them the Big Seven, we have made a project called the Abuse Information Exchange, and the idea here is that the exchange will subscribe to all these sources like Shadow Server and all the other sources where people report broken PCs, zombies, infected PCs, and other kinds of machine abuse. This is not for copyright abuse, and we don't want to have anything about that. The idea is then that the exchange will gather all the results, process them, and split them up by the AS number and send them to the ISPs themselves. So they only have to work with this data, and then are able to service their customers much more easier and much more quicker. And the quicker they can service their customer, the quicker the zombies and the other stuff is removed, and the better the internet will be. And I would like you to give you a report on the proceedings of the project. Currently, we are in a pilot phase. Getting the system up and running using Shadow Server data. And the plan is to go live in October with a fully re-engineering system where we get all kinds of sources as abuse reports come in. And I have two questions for you. One is, what can you do in your current setup to produce better abuse report once you see, for instance, in your firewall logs, that someone is missing or something is wrong? It doesn't harm yourself because you detected it and you just rejected it, but you want to report to the other guy that he is probably infected. So in this case, you can send the results to this intermediate party. A nice example is the Bredelab case, where the police had ransacked and confiscated all the servers of Bredelab, and the botnet that was made by Bredelab, it has to be dismantled. In this case, the police made a web server where all the zombies were going to, and they were given a pop-up that please fix your system. And this was the ignition for all kinds of other police ransomware viruses and malware. Who gives a police warning pop-up? Please fix your system. Go to this URL and pay this fee. So this didn't work. And what should have been done then is that the police just looks at the botnet and processes the amount of data through some kind of abuse exchange and let the abusers deal with it. And the abusers can more readily address their own customers and have the problems fixed. In this case, we want to have the system up and running in October. And I'm also asking for people who run similar processes or have reliable sources on which we can rely on to get abuse information from, so we can process and warn the customers in time. And this is about the status I could give you. If you have more, want to have more information, you can contact me at phons@planet.nl or visit me at the green tent next to the T3 tent, where I usually hang out. And you will hear more of us. The second question is, do people have problems in the way that abuse information, which could be privacy-related information, is processed in this way that that multiple parties will get involved? And we think we address these questions in the right way, so that the information will be gathered, but only processed for redirection to the correct ISPs where the abuse is coming from, and not to record anything for a long time for other reasons. Now, if someone has remarks or questions about that, then please step forward. This is the last talk, so questions are allowed.
Answers to your questions. Yes, we are doing this on a country level in Finland, have been doing it since 2005. Mm-hmm. And we have a project called Abuse Helper, which contains tools that you can use to make this happen. And the question number two, no, we have specific legislation in Finland that enables us to process abuse information when it's related to information security. Yeah.
The Abuse Helper project, we know about that, and we didn't choose to use Abuse Helper because there is we also want to see to have male abuse included in this system, and the problem with male abuse reports that they are coming in way longer than in current time.
I think we have to take this offline.
Yeah. Okay. I would certainly like that.